Well, tonight's awards are given for activities and accomplishments during the calendar year of 2015. For our 12 main categories, the judges for tonight's awards were selected from a cross-section of our community, and the committee has no part in the judging. For our four new business recognition categories, nominations were judged by the Chamber's Executive Committee. The winners tonight will be a surprise for all.
Now let's get to the awards. Our first category is for active adults, an individual or group age 60 or over who exemplifies meaningful contributions, strength of character, and commitment to our community.
And the nominees are Bob Fowler, a continued supporter of seniors for more than three decades. Bob was involved in the creation of many senior centers countywide and advocated for a senior day at the Kern County Fair. Brookdale Riverwalk Senior Runner Spirit Team spends hours practicing routines with Cal State Bakersfield's Spirit Squad and has strengthened the community's love of cheering for its hometown team. Dick Taylor works to improve the lives of teens through the Devil Pups Youth Program by teaching them about confidence, self-control, leadership, and good citizenship. Catherine Jordan, also known as Grandma Hoople, is a retired teacher who has dedicated her life to helping local children by promoting anti-bullying and literacy programs in our community.
And now to present the award, please welcome from our award sponsor from the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors, Mr. Nick Ortiz, President and CEO.
Thank you, Jim and Tammy. I'm back. I just want to say I am really blessed not only to work with an outstanding team of volunteers at the Chamber, to lead our team, but to work for some of the best bosses in our community. So from our chairman, Steve Murray, to all of our 25 board members who sponsored this category, I just say thank you for your commitment to the Chamber and to Bakersfield. And now the Crystal Camellia goes to Catherine Jordan, Grandma Whoople.
After more than 30 years as a dedicated teacher with the Kern High and Bakersfield City School Districts, Catherine Jordan decided to start a new career in her life by giving back to the community as an entertainer. Grandma Whoople, promoting anti-bullying and literacy among elementary and middle school students is Grandma Whoople's focus. In 2015, Grandma Whoople had the opportunity to visit local schools, daycares, and nonprofit organizations and churches as a storyteller and to donate books to children. She also held monthly book drives, reading carnivals in classrooms, and community outreach programs at city parks. Last year, Grandma Whoople handed out more than 31,000 books to kids to promote her motto, "Today's readers are tomorrow's leaders."
When I say Grandma, you say Whoople. Grandma, Whoople. Grandma, Whoople. Woo! First of all, I would like to thank the Bakersfield Chambers of Commerce Committee. I am humble, and I appreciate this award because I truly believe today's readers are tomorrow's leaders. Thank you.
Can I get an amen to that? Amen. Our next category is architecture and design. Honoring the completion of a new interior or exterior design, integrating the environment with space and materials.
And here are the nominees. Bakersfield Country Club. This local country club constructed a state-of-the-art health and wellness center that offers a six-lane lap pool, a gym, tennis courts, a spa, and more. Boys and Girls Club of Kern County's The Backyard, A grant from Wells Fargo Bank allowed a vacant lot to be transformed into a safe place for educational activities for club members as well as community events. David Y. Malazzo, AIA. Malazzo and Associates designed Building Y, a three-story office building in Southwest Bakersfield for California Resources Corporation. The unique design incorporates a mix of traditional California style and contemporary edginess. Dignity Health Memorial Hospital's Helen Taylor Cobbs Children's Healing Garden. This new garden sanctuary has become the center for the hospital's pediatric care unit, which provides a peaceful environment and strong therapeutic benefits. Hoffman Hospice Home. Kern County's first ever hospice home provides patients and their families an alternative to hospital or skilled nursing care. This home away from home contains a library, theater room, chapel, and more.
And the sponsor for this category is Kern Federal Credit Union, and the presenter is Ms. Miranda Whitworth, Marketing Manager.
Good evening. On behalf of Kern Federal Credit Union, I just want to express such gratitude to the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce and the committees that put this event together. We love Bakersfield at Kern Federal Credit Union and know when our neighbors from the Southland or from up north drive down the 99 freeway, they might have some questions about our town. This is truly a beautiful place, and when it comes to the aesthetics, we're happy to be able to see amazing architecture and beautiful design here in our city, and the more, the merrier. That's why we're proud to present this award tonight. And the Crystal Camellia goes to Hoffman Hospice.
One of only 250 hospice homes nationwide, the Hoffman Hospice Home opened its doors last year to provide an alternative to hospital and skilled nursing care for Kern County residents. This impressive 25,000 square foot, 18 suite facility is beautifully designed to provide 24-hour hospital level care in an extraordinary home-like setting. This luxurious brick building boasts a theater room, a library, two family lounges, dining parlor, and chapel that has a stunning stained glass window art piece picturing the River of Life. Hoffman Hospice Home is a place of consolation and serenity where patients and their families enjoy all of the comforts of home that make a lasting impact during such a precious time of life.
Ah! I didn't think we were going to win because we're in the back. And I thought, oh, we're not going to win. And we won. Thank you so much. First to the chamber. For this honor and to even be part of this exciting celebration. But I need to thank a couple people that I couldn't have got through this without. First, I'd like to thank Gretchen for decorating. We'd love to give you a tour. Please come look. She did that. And then I wouldn't be here, and this home wouldn't be what it is if it wasn't for our project manager, Gary Grumbles. He's my gift from God during this whole time. And I don't know if any of you know him. That's a little odd to say about Gary because he's ornery. And so, but he was my answer to prayer, and we got through it. And we thank you for letting us take care of your loved ones at such a trying time. It's an honor to us, and we'll love them and care for them until their time's up. Thank you.
Our next category is arts and culture. Efforts by a group or individual to improve or enhance the arts and culture within our community.
And the nominees are Eliza McCracken. She held a series of art exhibits and book programs throughout the community to inspire creativity and advocate for arts education. Evelyn C. Thomas, this instructor choreographs routines to highlight her dancers' abilities and build their confidence at Evelyn's Dance Studio, and also educates the community about the health benefits of dancing, something I've always subscribed to myself. McAuliffe Elementary Performing Arts Group, run by parent volunteer Karen Fussy, Kindergarten through sixth grade students are trained on all aspects of performing arts and have entertained at retirement homes, the Bakersfield Homeless Center, and the Jameson Center. Michelle and Ephraim Penn, this couple who owns Penn Point Dance Academy, inspires a love for performing through their dance studio and after-school programs while working to build character and discipline in their students. Rick Kreiser is the man behind an ongoing series called the Guitar Masters Concert Series, perhaps you've heard of it, which presents the world's best guitarists and instrumentalists in an intimate listening environment right here in Bakersfield. And finally, well, not finally, excuse me. This is a big category, lots of nominees. Stars Bakersfield Music Theater Restaurant. Since 1969, this dinner theater has allowed local actors to donate their time and talents by performing in shows for the community. The theater also trains performers through its after-school programs. Sylvia Guzman. For 30 years, Sylvia Guzman, director of Grupo Folklorico Escuela Unidas, has helped youth in our community learn the rich history and culture of Mexican folklore through dance and musical performances at an annual festival. The Arts Council of Kern transformed First Friday's Art Walk into a monthly fine arts event and extravaganza. If you haven't been there, it's a lot of fun. Featuring more than 75 local artists and live music while also supporting local shops and restaurants. And finally, Thomas Zachary, local artist who revitalized the city's largest mural that was in danger of fading away and created a new mural to honor all veterans of World War II.
Please welcome our award sponsor from Bright House Networks, Ms. Colleen Dillaway, Director of Sales and Marketing.
Long walk in high heels. Hello, friends. So Bright House Networks is a local employer employing more than 350 or so of your friends, neighbors, and colleagues. What matters the most to us and what we work hard every day to do is to connect our customers with what matters most to them. Now, we are a tireless supporter of the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce, and we are very happy to support in any way we possibly can tonight, but I am particularly pleased to be able to present tonight's Arts and Culture Award, because what better way to connect people than through arts and culture? So tonight's nominees, as you have all seen, have all been very spectacular in their own right, and I would like to congratulate each and every one of those nominees. So please give me just a minute to congratulate them. However, it is my honor and privilege to present tonight's Crystal Camellia to Mr. Rick Kreiser.
The Guitar Masters Concert Series began as a simple idea, which was to present the world's premier guitarists and instrumentalists in an intimate listening environment. Rick Kreiser founded this ongoing concert series in 2011. Which is now in its fifth season, having hosted more than 30 shows for 6,000 Bakersfield music lovers of all ages. Last season alone, more than 2,000 people attended 11 shows at 4 different venues, including American Sound Recording Studios, Edward J. Simonson Performing Arts Center at Bakersfield College, the Spotlight Theater, and the Bakersfield Music Hall of Fame. Guitar Masters also hosts clinics and lectures to further engage the artists with patrons.
Well, just how cool is this? So it was about 4.5 years ago or so that I had this idea, not a new idea, just to have some guitar players come, but I attended a house concert down in Westlake Village, and I heard this wonderful guitar player, and he was our first guest, Lawrence Juber, used to play with Paul McCartney, and I thought, how great would it be just to have a small, intimate show with great guitar players, and I realized that my house would not seat 50 people. So we start out at the Bell Tower, and we're now at the beautiful Bakersfield Music Hall of Fame. We've done 37 shows, and our underwriting sponsors, and really my family, and all you cool people that come to the shows are really the winners here. So I'd like to thank my wife, Lori, my daughter, Katie, who took every one of those pictures at every show, and all of our artists and patrons. Thanks very much. What an honor.
Yeah, Rick's a pretty good guitar player in his own right, by the way. He's going to be joining us for the Media Music Jam on June 22nd. He'll be joining forces with The Majestics as we raise money for the Kern County Cancer Fund on June 22nd at the Crystal Palace. So get your tickets now. Shameless plug. Shameless. All right. Well, congratulations to all of our recipients. We have many more to go. But at this time, we would like to acknowledge the beautiful Bakersfield Committee members, led by Committee Chair Kelly Custer, Castle and Cook, California, for all of their efforts and their hard work to make this evening possible. This was all done under the leadership of the Chamber's Hillary Haynes and Sarah Henzo, by the way. And so would everyone please stand and be acknowledged, those of you behind this wonderful event. I know that Sarah is around here. Thank you. Kelly Custer.
Earlier tonight, we hosted a reception, which is a very important part of tonight's awards show. We are proud to honor all of our nominees. In addition, each of our nominees was featured recently by the Bakersfield Californian, and all nominees will receive certificates following the program in recognition of their contributions to enhancing the quality of life in our community. Thank you to our presenting sponsor, Kern Schools Federal Credit Union, our audio-visual sponsor, Media Solutions Incorporated, and our media sponsor, KGET-TV17. And a very special thank you to all of tonight's nominees. Your contributions to our community truly help to make Bakersfield beautiful.
All right, our next category is education, recognizing efforts that promote or benefit education in our city at all levels. Tim?
Art Sherwin, an artist who has spent 40 years presenting and mentoring students, business leaders, and professional development groups, as well as donating his own artwork to local charities. Colonel Thomas Baker Book Education Project. Dozens of community supporters donated 1,200 copies of Colonel Baker's Field, an American Pioneer Story, to all middle and junior high schools throughout the greater Bakersfield area. Kern County Public Works Department, funded by the county's Public Works Department and facilitated by Community Clean Sweep, the Clean Kids Education Program teaches kids environmental stewardship, such as recycling and litter cleanup. Kern Rural Teacher Residency. Through a partnership with Cal State Bakersfield, this credential and master's degree program will provide more than 100 teachers with specialized knowledge, skills, and a passion for teaching in rural high-need settings. See Me Learn. 1 hour a week is all it took for the See Me Learn after-school program run by James Guineer to ignite a new passion for learning in dozens of students in the Bakersfield City School District. Sophia Felix. The Keep Bakersfield Beautiful Education Subcommittee, chaired by Sophia Felix, designed a presentation to promote the importance of recycling and litter cleanup that was given to local schools and community organizations. United Way of Kern County. The Born Learning Trails, which were installed last year, are an interactive, playful, and visible community engagement tool that promotes learning concepts, health, and parental bonding for young children.
The sponsor for this category is Era Energy LLC, and the presenter is Mr. Traco Matthews, Public Affairs Specialist. Please welcome him.
Good evening. Education is very important to us at Era Energy. It's important to us as a company, as employees, as parents, and as a community. So we are very pleased to sponsor the beautiful Bakersfield Award for Education, and we congratulate all of the nominees. This year, the Crystal Camellia goes to Kern Rural Teacher Residency. Congratulations.
The Kern Rural Teacher Residency is a 5-year grant awarded to the Cal State Bakersfield Teacher Education Department. Each cohort of residents participates in an 18-month-long multiple subject credential and master's program. This program will provide 105 teachers with specialized knowledge, skills, and a passion for teaching in high-need rural Kern County schools that will impact thousands of kindergarten through 8th grade students. Through a partnership with CSUB and 3 local school districts, teachers are partnered with veteran teachers and will also learn how to incorporate STEM practices in their curriculum. This program is dedicated to preparing teacher leaders with the cultural competency to make a significant impact in rural communities, which will foster future and positive change.
Thanks to the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce. We're just thrilled to be able to do the work that we do preparing teachers to teach in high-need rural areas. And passion and perseverance and, do you want to add anything?
Yeah.
That's it, thank you.
Our next category is environmental energy. An individual, group, or organization that promotes energy education and awareness or promotes the preservation and conservation of our local environment.
I should get an award for this, for how many times I've lectured my youngest son about taking a 5-minute shower. But anyway, that's beside the point. I don't want to tell that story, right? All right, here are the nominees. Kern Citizens for Energy. Tracy Leach and her team at Providence Consulting created a grassroots coalition whose mission is to educate local business groups and organizations about one of the community's main industry sectors. Kern Community College District's 21st Century Energy Center, a coalition with members of the San Joaquin Valley Electric Vehicle Partnership, resulted in the installation of 4 electric vehicle charging stations at the district's Weil Institute on Chester Avenue. Ray Scott, he oversees numerous events and his relentless promotion of recycling. He serves on various committees and has helped implement recycling programs locally that have now become models on the state and national level. SOS Recycle Center, owner Dave Smith's goal is to influence present and future generations about the benefits of recycling and change the perception of recycling centers to clean, service-friendly centers. The Wildlands Conservancy, Wind Wolves Preserve. As the largest privately owned nature preserve on the West Coast, it provides free outdoor education, land stewardship, and recreational opportunities for local families. And Think Green Pedicabs, the small business owned by Stephen Schrepfer, is dedicated to providing residents with a zero emission transportation option while they are attending events and shopping and dining in downtown Bakersfield. Stephen, have you gotten to work on the mister for those pedicabs right now? I think we could use some of those right now. All right.
And please welcome our award sponsor is Valley Clean Air Now. Please welcome our presenter, Ms. Katie Allen from Pacific Gas and Electric Corporate Relations Representative.
Thank you, Tammy and Jim, and good evening. I am very proud to be representing Valley Can this evening, who unfortunately could not be with us. But as you know, they are a proud supporter of the conservation of our local environment and very proud to sponsor this category. And just taking a look at all the nominees and hearing from Jim, they all deserve to be winners. So can we give them all a round of applause before I announce the winner? Phenomenal things that they're doing here each and every day in our community. So thank you to each of them. So without further ado, the Crystal Camellia Award goes to Think Green Pedicabs.
Stephen Schrepfer started Think Green Pedicabs with the intention of providing himself part-time work with healthy benefits. Before he knew it, Stephen owned 5 pedicabs and expanded his company to help clean up the urban streets and alleyways of Bakersfield by removing nearly 800 pounds of discarded recyclables. This small business is dedicated to providing residents with a green way to get around downtown Bakersfield. The pedicabs offer a zero emissions transportation option for individuals attending events, shopping, or dining in the metropolitan area. Think Green Pedicabs also has affordable mobile advertising and marketing opportunities for local businesses.
And no, it's not me. They're a phenomenal group, but no, Stephen's not here to accept, so I will accept on their behalf unless Kathy wants to. Okay.
I'm just here because I was the cheerleader that said it could happen downtown.
Oh, great.
And he has been making it happen, so it's not me, and it's not here. But this is so cool for downtown.
Oh, great.
And it's all part of it, and it's the team that's making it happen downtown. It's not me. It's those that are making it happen. And thank you to Stephen, he's not here.
Yeah.
But he has a vision and a dream, and it's all about downtown.
And he's making it happen. So thank you, Stephen, and thank you, Think Green Pedicabs.
Thank you, Kathy Butler. All right. Now, moving on to our next category, it is the health category, and this award recognizes an individual, a group, or an organization that has made a significant contribution toward healthy living in Bakersfield through education, prevention, and medical services.
Here are the nominees. The Alzheimer's Disease Association of Kern County Incorporated. This organization offers various support groups along with adult day care and respite care to ensure Alzheimer's patients and their caregivers live a life of independence and dignity. Christopher Hamilton, MD at Southern California Orthopedic Institute. Dr. Hamilton donates his time treating sports-related injuries free of charge to student athletes. He provides sports medicine coverage on the sidelines at high school football games and has made significant contributions to several local athletic departments. Foundation for Movement, Inc. Move to Improve at Total Woman Fitness provides low-cost, low-impact, and low-intensity exercise programming in an encouraging environment for people with physical limitations to help improve their strength, mobility, and reach their fitness goals. Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation, Central Valley. JDRF is dedicated to supporting, mentoring, and providing support groups for children and families who are diagnosed with both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Nirav C. Naik, MD at New Life Weight Loss and Lifestyle Solutions. Empowers patients to take control of their overall health by providing free nutritional seminars at the Community Health Fair at the Kern County Fair and the Health and Wellness Expo. One Legacy. This organization promotes organ, tissue, and cornea donation awareness at schools, hospitals, and community events. Last year, 25 organ donors transplanted 79 life-saving organs from heroes in the Kern County area. Sensei Scott Milam of Golden Tiger Karate. With a belief that healthy living starts at a young age, Sensei Milam offers a variety of classes so that every student, regardless of age or ability, has the opportunity to learn martial arts. The AIS Cancer Center at San Joaquin Community Hospital. This comprehensive outpatient cancer center not only participated in numerous community projects, but held events to raise awareness, offer education, celebrate cancer survivors, and provide screenings to improve the community's understanding of cancer. Telehealth Docs Medical Group. This local business allows patients to connect with physicians for specialized and quality medical care via a secure technology platform that utilizes video conferencing instead of making a trip to a doctor's office.
The sponsor of this award is the Vascular and Leg Center, and the presenter is Dr. Amol Gupta. Please welcome him.
Thank you, guys. On behalf of Dr. Vinod Kumar and all the staff at the Vascular and Leg Center, we want to thank all of these nominees for giving us such a beautiful Bakersfield to live in and be proud of. Please give them a round of applause. You know, we feel really fortunate to belong to this medical community because I remember there were times when we had to go to Santa Barbara for specialist medical care, and that doesn't happen anymore. So our health community has really contributed in a big way. And today we want to congratulate one such healthcare organization or individual. Dr. Kumar always tells me, Pehla Sukh Nirogi Kaya, this is a Hindi motto, which means the first blessing in life is a positive health. And so the organization that has best exemplified this motto is Alzheimer's Disease Association of Kern County. Congratulations.
The Alzheimer's Disease Association of Kern County is simply all about families helping families. ADAKC offers respite care to ensure Alzheimer's patients and their caregivers live a life of independence and dignity. Some of the daily social activities at ADAKC include dancing, singing, piano playing, pet therapy, and even baseball. During 2015, ADAKC provided more than 69,000 hours of service in its adult daycare to seniors and disabled adults with Alzheimer's or other forms of dementia. This would not be possible without 500 volunteers who help to provide services such as caregiver education, support groups, clerical functions, fundraising efforts, and trainings. The organization outgrew its current location, so in October, ADAKC broke ground on a new facility that will allow it to triple the number of individuals it serves. Last November, ADAKC spread Alzheimer's awareness with its campaign, The Heart Never Forgets, and received more than 600 new inquiries before the end of the year.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much. We have such an amazing community, and for so long, so many people did not want to speak about Alzheimer's. There's no cure. It's not fun. We at ADAKC are turning something so negative into something so positive. These amazing people back here who run the show every day, it can't go on without them. Kate Yusey, our CEO, has been running it for almost 10 years, and they're amazing. If you've never been out to ADAKC, please come check it out. If you've never been touched by Alzheimer's, you are so blessed. This room is filled with so many people from our community, and I'm so proud to be here. I just have one favor. If the next week you can go out and ask a couple people that you know, friends or family, if they've ever heard of ADAKC, just to spread the word, to help us. It's so much easier for us to bring it up than somebody to come talk about Alzheimer's, because it's such a scary disease. Nobody wants to talk about Alzheimer's or dementia. So please help us spread the word. We're here for you. You're not alone on this journey. And thank you to everyone back here. Thank you to this community for supporting us. We're the only nonprofit local social atmosphere for our loved ones on the Alzheimer's journey. And we're doing big things in the community. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Our next category is humanitarian individual, an individual whose personal efforts have contributed to the community as a whole.
And the nominees are Eliza McCracken. Through her community outreach art book program, Eliza has worked to expand awareness of the local arts community and to be an advocate for arts education. Danny Morrison, local radio personality, motivational speaker, and community activist. Danny spends countless hours volunteering for different causes throughout our community and also mentors children. Detective Varian Coleman Jr., this Bakersfield police officer, participates in Shop with a Cop. He prepares and delivers food baskets during the holiday to disadvantaged families in need, and he's also a youth minister at his church. Doug Bennett started a local organization focused on educating the community on the dangers of human trafficking, and he runs a shelter to help survivors of human trafficking rebuild their lives. Dr. Vincent K. Jones, as the pastor of the People's Missionary Baptist Church, Pastor Jones organized a church conference that brought hundreds of people to Bakersfield, bringing in a lot of money for local businesses and community, and I would suspect providing an uplifting spiritual experience as well. Mayor Harvey Hall, over the course of his tenure as mayor of Bakersfield, Harvey L. Hall has donated his entire mayor's salary to fund scholarships for students to help them reach their educational goals. Nanette Gonzalez founded a nonprofit organization that provided legitimate foster care and adoptions in Romania and teaches the children of Bakersfield the gift of giving by collecting items for the babies and the children in her care. Natisha Johnson organizes various events that benefit families and senior citizens in need. She mentors children and young adults, and she serves on several boards such as the Bakersfield City School District Education Foundation and the Kern County Black Chamber of Commerce.
Our sponsor for this award is Pacific Gas and Electric. Please welcome Ms. Denise Newton, Senior Manager of Local Customer Experience.
Good evening. I'm honored to be here this evening representing Pacific Gas and Electric Company and our over 500 employees that live and work here in Kern County. Beautiful Bakersfield allows us to recognize those individuals, businesses, and organizations that give so much to make this community a wonderful and special place to live and work. So I wanted to thank and congratulate all of the nominees. So if we could all give them a hand. I'm excited to announce the Crystal Camellia Award is Doug Bennett.
As founder and executive director of Magdalene Hope's Restoration Ranch Women's Shelter, Doug Bennett helped rescue 13 women involved in human trafficking last year and provided the tools and resources to help rebuild their lives. Doug educates the community on the dangers of human trafficking. In 2015, Doug co-produced and premiered a documentary titled The Trafficked Life, which was filmed right here in Kern County. He also has a partnership with the Kern County Public Health Department that allows his organization to provide free HIV/AIDS testing and information.
Oh, wow. Thank you, Jim and Tammy. That's crazy. I know I could probably speak for the other nominees. We don't do this to get an award. We do this out of our passion and our compassion for people. So with that, I'd like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, first and foremost. The Chamber of Commerce, thank you so much. My fellow nominees who have impacted and continue to affect change throughout our wonderful city. Thank you. Of course, I'm going to thank my wife, Angie. I cannot do any of this stuff without my wife, and she's not behind me. She's at my side, and she's my biggest cheerleader, and I love you, and I appreciate you very much. I'd like to thank my two daughters, Madeline and Paisley, for sharing me with everyone else, my parents, family, and friends, the staff at Restoration Ranch, Magdalene Hope Board of Directors and volunteers, and every woman that I've been able to rescue out of human trafficking. Thank you. To all those that I've listed, this one's for us. Thank you for helping me do what I do. Thank you so much. God bless.
Before we continue with the awards, we'd like to take a moment to remind all of the nominees that we will be presenting the Chairman's Award at the end of the program. This award is chosen from among all nominee submissions and given to the nominee that is recognized for overall excellence. Now on to the next category.
And that would be the humanitarian group category, a group whose combined efforts have contributed to the community as a whole.
And the nominees are Bakersfield Chapter, The Lynx Incorporated, operates the Lynx Leadership Academy STEM Ulation, which exposes 7th and 8th grade students to STEM-related career options through hands-on activities, field trips, and access to professionals. Bakersfield Condors. This hockey team hosts several fundraisers for local nonprofits, such as the annual Teddy Bear Toss and Sock Toss Sunday. The Condors also donate game tickets and player memorabilia for auctions. Bellissima Medical Aesthetics. This local business is building up the community by donating hundreds of gift certificates and baskets totaling thousands of dollars to various nonprofits to help these organizations meet their fundraising goals. Helping One Woman Bakersfield Chapter. This organization helps local women who have suffered a devastating loss restore their lives by honoring them at a girls' night out dinner. Kern County Builders Exchange sponsored a collaborative effort with its members to provide the Hope House, a comfortable place for families to stay while their loved ones are treated at Dignity Health Bakersfield Memorial Hospital. Valley Bible Fellowship. This congregation actively looks to give back to the communities less fortunate. They donate meals during the holidays, provide backpacks and school supplies, and coordinate neighborhood cleanup efforts and more.
The sponsor of this award is Chevron, and please welcome the presenter, Miss Amy Edwards, General Manager of Operations. Amy.
Thank you, Jim. It's my honor and pleasure to be here with you tonight and represent Chevron and our employees. Chevron is proud to call Bakersfield home. It's a wonderful community to live and a great place to do business. We give back to the communities where we live and work each year and promote volunteerism for worthy causes. We also deliver reliable energy so that Kern County can create jobs and build a better future for California. Chevron congratulates and appreciates all of the nominees, and if we could, if give them one more round of applause. And the winner of the Crystal Camellia Award is Valley Bible Fellowship.
The congregation of Valley Bible Fellowship actively looks to give back to the communities less fortunate and show people they are cared for and loved. In 2015, Valley Bible Fellowship donated meals to 150 families during the Thanksgiving season, provided backpacks and school supplies to more than 500 children, gave 1,000 children a present at the Christmas toy giveaway, coordinated neighborhood cleanup efforts, and much more. The church's Plus One Ministry selects a family in need each quarter and surprises them with an act of kindness, whether that be a new roof, new tires on the family car, or a furnished home.
So unfortunately, Valley Bible Fellowship was not able to join us tonight, so I'll accept this on their behalf. Thank you.
Our next category is Life as It Should Be, Civic or Nonprofit. This is for the coordination of efforts that have enhanced the quality of life in Bakersfield.
A lot of nominees here as well. The American Cancer Society. This organization provides several free services for cancer patients and their families. It educates residents about how to lower their cancer risks, and it holds several large events annually, including the Relay for Life, to raise money for cancer research. Art and Spirituality Center at Dignity Health Mercy and Memorial Hospitals. Run by volunteers, the center is designed to use the arts to help patients and their families heal, both physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Bakersfield Pride. To help promote and celebrate community pride in a safe environment, Bakersfield LGBTQ planned and hosted its 12th annual Bakersfield Pride Festival. Campus Gamers at CSUB. These guys are hard workers, man, I'm telling you. Last year, this group raised more than $30,000 during a 12-hour-long community gaming marathon to benefit the Lauren Small Children's Medical Center at Dignity Health Bakersfield Memorial Hospital. Wish I could have been there for that one. I missed that one. I don't know how I missed it. Dustin's Diner, a longtime neighborhood tradition, continues to sell hot chocolate, cookies, and other treats to families looking at holiday lights in Hagen Oaks. Last year, $15,000 was donated to the Bakersfield Homeless Center. Keep Bakersfield Beautiful. This nonprofit side of the city's solid waste division, Keep Bakersfield Beautiful, has built connections to coordinate beautification projects, litter and graffiti cleanups, urban gardens, and community-wide recycling events. And finally, Smile for a Lifetime Foundation, with the mission to create self-confidence and inspire hope by providing the gift of a smile. This organization awarded free orthodontic care scholarships to 24 students last year.
Our sponsor for this award is Castle & Cook, California. Please welcome Ms. Darlene Mulkey, Vice President of Sales and Marketing.
Thank you, everyone. This is by far one of my favorite nights of the year. We get to come together and we get to celebrate what makes this community so wonderful. At Castle & Cook, we've spent the last 28 years building communities where we feel like our residents can thrive and enjoy their life. But really, it is the residents of all communities that breathe the vitality and make this place life as it should be. So it is a pleasure to represent all the nominees tonight in every category. They have been amazing. It's been an amazing night so far. So without further ado, I'd like to give the Crystal Chameleon Award in the category as Life as It Should Be to Keep Bakersfield Beautiful.
Since its inception, Keep Bakersfield Beautiful has become the mecca for efforts to beautify Bakersfield and its surrounding areas. Keep Bakersfield Beautiful works with various nonprofits, businesses, and organizations to coordinate beautification projects, litter and graffiti cleanups, urban gardens, and community-wide recycling events. In 2015, there were more than 13,000 volunteers who signed up to clean up the city as part of the Great American Cleanup and the Greater Bakersfield Green Expo. And this organization's influence stretches beyond the borders of Kern County. Two members, Lewis Gill and Sal Moretti, were asked to do a presentation at Harvard University regarding the city's partnership with the Bakersfield Homeless Center to clean up local roadways.
Good evening, everyone. Wow, what an honor. First of all, I want to thank everybody who's behind me and everybody who's here. It is an incredible effort. It takes collaboration of so many people to make this a beautiful Bakersfield. Thank you so much for the Mayor Hall. You've been an inspiration to keep Bakersfield beautiful. It is your last year as a mayor, but hopefully you will stay on this committee because we cannot do it without you. And thank you to all these people here. Without them and thousands of volunteers in Bakersfield, none of this can possibly happen. So thank you again. And everybody who's in this category, you're all amazing. Thank you so much.
Our next category is Public-Private Partnership. This award goes for the use of public-private funds in a partnership effort to enhance the quality of life in our community.
And here are the nominees. Cal State Bakersfield's Office of Events, Transwest Security Service e-ticket program. This partnership streamlined how students received tickets to the university's commencement ceremonies by utilizing an electronic ticket system, and it helped cut down on paper waste and volunteer hours. Chef Suzanne Durst and Professor Leah Carter of Bakersfield College, Emily Aldred, M's Treat'em Sweet. 4 years ago, Emily Aldred started a business to make and deliver holiday treats, and she donated the proceeds to local nonprofits. Last year, 15-year-old Emily partnered with Bakersfield College's Culinary Arts Department to use their commercial kitchen and student volunteers to streamline the production process. Children First Campaign, Bright House Networks, IKEA Distribution Center, Tech the Halls Project. This project works to bridge the digital divide by providing refurbished computers, desks, chairs, and low-cost, high-speed internet to low-income families in East Bakersfield. Friends of the Kern County Library Incorporated. With the support of dozens of volunteers, this nonprofit helps endorse library programs, purchases materials, coordinates used book sales, and funds the countywide summer reading program. The Tehachapi Mountain Beer and Wine Festival. It's become a premier summer festival that provides needed funding for local nonprofits. It also brings substantial tourism dollars to the local economy and highlights the area's local breweries.
The sponsor for this award is J.P. Morgan Chase and Company, and the presenter, please welcome Mr. Jason Chamberlain.
Thank you, sir. I wanted to thank everybody. J.P. Morgan and Chase is proud to present this award. We at J.P. Morgan truly believe that the partnership between public and private corporations is crucial to the success of our thriving community. So, without any further ado, the Crystal Camellia goes to Chef Suzanne Durst, the Professional Lake Carter, Bakersfield College, and Emily Arter.
Four years ago, Emily Aldrit started a business called Treat 'em Sweet to make and deliver holiday treats. Emily donated the proceeds to the Bakersfield Homeless Shelter and the Alliance Against Family Violence and Sexual Assault. Now, at 15 years old, Emily and her family outgrew their kitchen and reached out to Bakersfield College's Culinary Arts Department for assistance. Through the partnership, BC's Chef Suzanne Durst and Professor Leah Carter allowed Emily to use the college's commercial kitchen and helped recruit student volunteers to streamline the production process. In 2015, the students were able to cook and bake more than 1,500 bags of sweets and 124 loaves of pumpkin bread, which resulted in raising nearly $11,000 for the two nonprofits.
Thank you for both Emily and I. And all I can say is I wouldn't be standing here if it weren't for this amazing young lady.
I'd just like to thank the Bakersfield College Culinary Department and the wonderful partnership that they have with M's Treat 'em Sweet. The Treat 'em Sweet team and I could not be as successful and helpful to those in need without them. So thank you so much. It's great.
And just on another note, this Christmas time, reach out to us and order some product from us so we can do twice the amount of work that we did last year.
And what a year it has been for Emily. She also won a Heroes Award from the American Red Cross. She's busy. Our next category is Renovation Tenant Improvement. This is for the completion of a renovated design that upgrades an existing structure and or incorporates the use of landscaping to enhance the aesthetic value of the property.
And the nominees are Era Energy LLC, transformed a collection of meeting rooms and hallways into Era Academy, which serves as a learning center and also utilizes visual teaching tools to highlight the many facets of oil production, Era's company history, and more. Bakersfield Art Association, after outgrowing their former gallery, members refurbished an old antique shop and redesigned it into a new space to showcase and nurture the local art scene. Bakersfield Music Hall of Fame, an old freight loading facility, was converted into a music recording and performing arts venue to preserve Bakersfield's rich musical heritage. Bakersfield Pediatrics and Valley Children's Hospital, an existing medical building near Dignity Health Bakersfield Memorial Hospital, was expanded and renovated to provide a new clinic that allows local families to seek specialized care for their children without having to travel far. Buena Vista Museum of Natural History and Science. Donations from the community helped the museum update its exterior with bright paint and a new logo design, making it more attractive and visible to the public. Chain Cone Styles turned one of the city's oldest buildings into a modern workplace for the law firm's 30 employees, which also helped to contribute to ongoing efforts to revitalize downtown Bakersfield. Comprehensive Blood and Cancer Center. The expansion of 18 private infusion therapy rooms, a French restaurant, and medical and administrative offices allows CBCC to better serve its patients. Timbler Brewing Company, a previous industrial space, was transformed into a new brewery and community entertainment venue.
The sponsor for this award is DoubleTree by Hilton. Please welcome Mr. Carlos Navarro, General Manager.
Thank you, Jim and Tammy. On behalf of the entire staff here at the DoubleTree Hilton Bakersfield, thank you for being here and allowing us to serve all of you and allowing us to participate in this year's beautiful Bakersfield Awards. I'm honored to be able to present the winner of this year's award for renovation tenant improvement. And the Camellia goes to Bakersfield Pediatrics and Valley Children's Hospital.
Bakersfield Pediatrics and Valley Children's Hospital developed a partnership to bring the first pediatric subspecialty clinic to Kern County. An existing medical building near Dignity Health Bakersfield Memorial Hospital was expanded and renovated, providing more exam rooms and additional administrative areas. The building's natural history theme concept and artifacts were provided by Dr. Javier Bustamante, a local pediatrician. This new clinic allows local families to seek specialized care for their children without having to travel many miles to Los Angeles or Madera.
You want to talk? You want me to do it? Yeah. This is pretty incredible. What a fantastic group of nominees. I'm really excited to have this opportunity. It took a long time to put this project together, and there's a lot of people to thank. Mark Ingeline, Brad Henderson of IBI Group, Gina Atani with Atani Design Concepts, Bree Wattenville. We had Dave Weitzel, general contractor. A lot of great people that I'm probably gonna forget. We're really proud to have a concept here to bring pediatric subspecialty care into a clinic setting. To create an opportunity where families didn't have to take time off work, travel, just bring a lot more care, and it's great for the 34th Street corridor and great for Bakersfield. So we're excited.
And I'd like to thank my partner, Derek, and business as well as project director for this project. All the participants did an absolutely wonderful job. I'd like to thank the chamber and this facility for hosting, especially the host. Who I admire greatly. And thank you all for coming and supporting us. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. Our next category celebrates our youth. An individual or group 20 years or younger who, through personal involvement and endeavors, has answered the call of good citizenship.
The nominees are Centennial High School Interact Club. Amidst the red shirts of CHS Interactors, leadership is very visible, whether it's engaging in projects that provide funds and assistance to the homeless or repair and refurbish the Ronald McDonald House. These students are always excited to lend a helping hand. Emily Wolf, despite already being dedicated to several school and community activities, this Centennial High School student accepted the opportunity to be the first Interact District Governor for the Rotary District 5240. Since July, Emily's job has been to connect and improve all 74 Interact clubs in the district to help them establish longevity. Ethan Francis, as Vice President of North High School's Future Farmers of America chapter, and serving as a leader of Calvary Bible Church Harbor's youth group, Ethan was a member of the 2015-2016 Ford Dimension and Dream Builders team that helped launch a cyberbullying campaign. Ayana Blanton, this sixth grader turned a fun crafting project into an effort to raise money for animals by making and selling rubber band bracelets to raise money for nonprofits that help local animals. Katie Collins and Rin Lee, since joining Stockdale High School's National Honor Society, this dynamic duo has received pure joy from brightening people's lives. Whether that be assisting children with autism at the Lego workshop put on by the Kern Autism Network or feeding the homeless. McAuliffe Elementary Student Body. Each year, the student body at McAuliffe Elementary School hosts a canned food drive to bless 10 families who are in need. The students collect supplies to support a holiday dinner and gifts for family members. West High School Interact Club. With more than 30 students involved in West High School's Interact Club, numerous families, children, and local veterans were helped last year from projects like Adopt a Family for Christmas or the Great American Cleanup. And lastly, West High Lifesavers. Last year, 76 participants on the youth team from West High School raised $100 each to participate in the 24-hour Relay for Life that benefits the American Cancer Society.
The sponsor for this award is It's Your Party Event Services. And please welcome our presenter, Ms. Janine Johnson, the owner.
Wow, what a night. I can't tell you I'm not nervous, but it's so amazing to think 3 years ago I would have never thought I'd be up here. And it's such an honor because without our youth, what are we? And I am so honored to be a sponsor tonight. I love working with our community. I have grown to love, I was born in Bakersfield but moved away and just came back almost 10 years ago. Never thought I'd be so involved in this community that I love so much now. And this is definitely home. And I am so glad to give the Crystal Camellia Award to Centennial High School Interactive Club.
This service group of more than 100 young leaders exemplifies the service above self motto. The Centennial High School Interact Club is constantly striving to find creative ways to make life better for everyone. Last year, CHS Interactors engaged in projects that provided funds and assistance to the homeless, repaired and refurbished the Ronald McDonald House, and assisted grade schools with drama productions. This club receives numerous phone calls from the community asking for help, and these students plan and organize ways to lend a helping hand.
Not told I was going to speak. I was asked a while ago to be the district governor for Interact, but I was torn by the idea because I didn't want to leave the kids behind me because Centennial Interact has just been absolutely amazing. I have to thank our school administration for always being there for us when we have a crazy idea for fundraising or anything. They're always there. And of course, our amazing Rotary, Twilight, for always just having the same energy as the youth and the same energy to support the community that we've given back to. But I think the biggest person that we need to thank is not only Ms. Gibbs, our advisor, but Bakersfield itself for having so many amazing community outreach programs and just so many amazing events for us just to be there and volunteer for, but even participate in and really grow to love our community. So thank you.
I know Emily wants me to say a few words, but it's about the youth and it's about them and all the work they've done. Please give them a round of applause. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Now we are going to move on to the four new categories added to this year's award show that recognize businesses in our community. These four categories were judged by the Chamber Executive Board of Directors. Our next category, Business Person of the Year. A local business owner whose efforts truly impact and enhance the quality of life in our community.
Some familiar names on this list. Start with Ben Stenson. Ben Stenson is the president, of course, of Stenson's, a local company that has sold office supplies since 1947. Many local causes and nonprofits have benefited from Ben's generosity over the years, including the Bakersfield Homeless Center, the Boys and Girls Clubs of Kern County, and local animal shelters. Keith Bryce, Mid-State Development Corporation. Keith is the president and CEO of Mid-State Development Corporation, which partners with commercial lenders to finance owner-occupied commercial, industrial, real estate, and equipment. Keith is also an active volunteer and community supporter on various organizations, including the United Way of Kern County, the South Bakersfield Kiwanis, Kern Economic Development Corporation, and the Kern Community Foundation. Mike Gregg, Elite Auctions and Fundraising Services, a professional auctioneer and consultant for more than 14 years. Mike's primary focus is fundraising events for nonprofits and schools. This Bakersfield native has done charity auctions for various local nonprofits, including Make-A-Wish Foundation, Garces Memorial High School, Bakersfield West Rotary, Bakersfield Association of Realtors. Robin Brassfield Cooper, Robin's EnviroVac. Well represented here tonight. Robin began her oil field maintenance business in 1999 with just two employees. Now her business employs 40 people. A firm believer in helping the community, Robin has supported nearly 40 local nonprofit and community organizations that focus on the youth of our community. And finally, Stephanie Lowry, Tris Technology Solutions. All right, got shouted down. That's Tris Technology Solutions. Along with her husband, Josh Lowry, Stephanie owns Tris Technology Solutions, as you might gather. It's a technology company and an IT company, and Stephanie is an active volunteer in the community. And last fall, Stephanie launched a networking group for other women professionals called Boss Ladies, which stands for Business Opportunities for Support and Success.
And please welcome the award sponsor, Bakersfield Mayor Harvey Hall.
Business is such a viable part of our Bakersfield community. And you've seen by tonight the number of businesses that were nominated for the various awards. I certainly want to congratulate the nominees in this category. And I want all of you to continue to realize the importance of all of your business efforts in reducing unemployment in our Bakersfield community. We still enjoy single-digit unemployment. It's my honor to give recognition for the Crystal Camellia Award for Business Person of the Year, Robin Brassfield Cooper.
As a woman working in the oil fields in the 1990s, Robin Brassfield Cooper had the opportunity to learn from great mentors. With advice from some field operators at Chevron, Robin began her own oil field maintenance business, Robin's EnviroVac, in 1999 with two employees. Today, her business employs 40 people. She has broadened her understanding of industry and energy issues with professional growth through training, networking, and collaboration by being an active member of Western States Petroleum Association, the California Independent Petroleum Association, and the Alliance of Women in Energy, among other organizations. She's a firm believer in helping the community and has supported nearly 40 local nonprofit and organizations that focus on youth.
Wow, I'm really honored. Wow. I'm speechless. I'm really sorry. I really thank each and every one of you. Yeah, I was born and raised here, and kids are my world. I always just think about whenever I go to a ball game and the kids are selling their box of candy bars, how there's no way I would not give that baby a dollar, you know? That just means the world to me. They're out there trying to make a difference with their life and their future. So I just try to do the best that I can, and along with all of my family and all their friends out here, and I thank you. Thank you, the Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce. You guys are great. Thank you so much.
The nominees in this category are Bright House Networks. This corporation has a long-standing tradition of serving their customers by supporting the community in which everyone lives and works. It funds Bright Futures Laptop Scholarships, which provides local graduating seniors with a laptop and software to assist their post-high school educational goals. The company also launched an initiative called Connect to Complete, which provides affordable internet and devices to students and families who qualify for the National School Lunch Program. Chevron. Last year alone, Chevron invested $5 million to enhance STEM education for students, improve health outcomes for people, and promote economic development throughout the region. Chevron partnered with Kern County Superintendent of Schools, Cal State Bakersfield, and Bakersfield College to expand STEM educational programs for local students and educators. Its employees also logged more than 12,000 volunteer hours, and Chevron was also the top producing team for Relay for Life, netting nearly $80,000. GEI Consultants, a firm of engineers and scientists that has served the county's agriculture districts by engineering, designing, and overseeing the construction of conveyance canals, pumping plants, and pipeline irrigation systems. GEI Consultants provides internships for engineering students at Cal State Bakersfield and also supports key programs at the university. Pacific Gas and Electric Company strives to be a business that customers trust and choose to do business with by providing safe, reliable, green, and affordable energy. PG&E has supported various projects and organizations, including partnering with the Boys and Girls Clubs of Kern County on a summer jobs program. And it also works extensively on outreach efforts to educate customers about energy-saving measures and programs, as well as safety initiatives. TBC Media, serving as the community's source for news and information for more than 100 years, the Bakersfield Californian has rebranded itself into TBC Media to encompass not only the newspaper, but the company's digital platforms and magazines. TBC Media also coordinates and sponsors several community events to promote healthy living for its subscribers and their families. Wells Fargo. This financial services company is committed to improving the region it serves through community development, financial education, affordable housing, environmental stewardship, and charitable giving. Wells Fargo launched the Home Lift program in 2015, providing $15,000 in down payment assistance grants and program support. It also donated a $384,000 grant to help fund the completion of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Kern County's The Backyard Project.
The presenter for this, or the sponsor for this award, excuse me, is Young Woldridge, LLP, and please welcome our presenter, our friend Frank Woldridge, lead investigator. Frank.
Good evening, everyone. Great business in Bakersfield has nothing to do with logos, has very little to do with Facebook likes, does it? But it's a lot to do with the people that work in those companies, you and I, the hardworking individuals that provide their services, their time, a product. And even though it was very difficult to pick one individual company out of this elite group, the committee had to pick one. But I was particularly impressed with this particular company's service that they provide to this city. They provide jobs. They provide institutional loans. And with that being said, I'd like to present the Crystal Camellia Award this year to Wells Fargo.
Wells Fargo is a financial services company that values people, communities, and the environment. It remains committed to the regions it serves, including the Kern County area, through community development, financial education, affordable housing, environmental stewardship, and charitable giving. In June 2015, Wells Fargo launched the Home Lift program, which provided $15,000 in down payment assistance grants and program support, totaling $4.1 million to eligible home buyers. Last year, Wells Fargo also donated a $384,000 grant to help fund the completion of the Boys and Girls Club of Kern County's Backyard Project. At its 2015 Community Partners Breakfast last October, Wells Fargo presented a total of $50,000 in grants to 50 community partners.
I just have to say we're honored to be able to get this award, but it's truly in the benefit of our Bakersfield community. We really feel it's important to help our community be successful, and that's where we believe our pride and dedication is too. And we always make sure we have volunteers out there giving back to the community. So at the end of the day, it's about Bakersfield. So thank you so much from Wells Fargo. And Gabby, do you have anything, or Ricardo?
No.
Thank you so much.
Our next category is Nonprofit of the Year. The contributions of a 501c3 nonprofit organization that enhanced the community.
Not surprising, there are a lot of nominees in this category. Starting with Advanced Center for Eye Care, providing services for uninsured and underinsured populations, including eye exams, eye disease management, and sight restoration surgeries. This organization gave free eye exams and eyeglasses to nearly 1,300 students across Kern County. Alzheimer's Disease Association of Kern County, with a mission to improve the lives of Kern County residents living with Alzheimer's disease and related disorders, ADAKC provides various services, including its adult day center, support groups, and educational workshops. The nonprofit also raised $2.5 million through the Heart Never Forgets capital campaign to build a new state-of-the-art facility. Assistance League of Bakersfield. This all-volunteer nonprofit organization works to ensure all children have appropriate clothing for the new school year. In 2015, this nonprofit partnered with three Target stores and provided shopping experiences for more than 2,300 kids. Autism Society, Kern Autism Network, is working to improve the lives of individuals and their families living with autism. Its Lego workshops address fine motor skills, peer interactions, and community outreach with high school youth acting as mentors. Boys and Girls Club of Kern County, the nation's largest Boys and Girls Club, providing a safe haven for more than 7,200 children and youth ages 5 to 17. After school each day at three traditional clubs and 59 school-based sites. Last year, the club launched a nutrition program that served about 8,400 meals every month. Clinica Sierra Vista. For more than 44 years, Clinica Sierra Vista has been serving the low-income, underserved, marginalized, and hard-to-reach populations in the southern San Joaquin Valley. It opened two new clinics to provide high-quality, integrated and family-based preventative and primary care services. Hoffman Hospice, Kern County's only nonprofit hospice. Hoffman Hospice provides physical, spiritual, and emotional support to hundreds of terminally ill patients and their families on an annual basis. Last year, Hoffman Hospice staff cared for more than 1,200 patients and opened the county's first and only hospice home, providing patients and their families with an alternative to hospital or skilled nursing care. Hearts Connection, a parent-driven organization that assists parents of special needs children and adults in Kern County. This organization provides support groups, hosts community events to raise awareness, and partnered with the Kern County Library to hold sensory store time for infants and toddlers. No Kill Kern, a dog rescue program that rehabilitates and finds homes for dogs that would otherwise be euthanized in our local shelters. Last year, the group saved more than 100 dogs and one emu. And helps to educate the public about each individual story. Rose Mentor Program. Female high school students are partnered with professional women for a structured mentoring program. Once a month, Students attend events and receive tips on finances, interviewing techniques, dining, etiquette, and much more. Since its inception, the program has helped more than 1,000 women, and recruitment now takes place at 22 local high schools.
For the sponsor for this award is the Kern Community Foundation. Please welcome Ms. Kristen Barnes, President and CEO.
Good evening. The Kern Community Foundation is based on one simple thought, and that is growing community, growing philanthropy. When Nick and I first spoke about this award, it was without hesitation that the foundation felt that it was just so important to recognize the nonprofit community. We saw a glimpse of organizations this evening. They represent some of the hundreds of wonderful organizations that make our community a better place. At the foundation, we work tirelessly throughout the year to build visibility, to strengthen capacity, and to provide resources for sustainability for our nonprofit partners. So this evening, I am honored to present the very first nonprofit of the year. And that award goes to Advanced Center for Eye Care.
The Advanced Center for Eye Care provides services for uninsured or underinsured populations, including eye exams, eye disease management, and sight restore surgeries. In 2015, ACE performed almost 10,000 direct patient appointments and 292 sight restoring surgeries. This organization gave free eye exams and eyeglasses to nearly 1,300 students right here in Kern County, and believes through better eye care, these children will learn effectively and be at par with their peers inside and outside of the classroom.
Thank you, Jim and Ms. Tammy. Here we go. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of our Executive Director, Justin Cave, the Board of Directors, two of which are here with me today, two of whom are with me today, Dr. Vindang and Dr. Neil Shardut. I think I'm going to forget some names. I saw Michael Bauer in the audience today. The entire staff and management of this Advanced Center for Eye Care, on behalf of the uninsured, underinsured residents of Kern County whom we serve, thank you so much to the Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce and to everyone who had an eye on this decision. Get it? Six years ago, ACE started as a seed of vision. Get it? By the brothers, Doctors Joe and Daniel Chang, and this seed was planted, it was nurtured and cared for over the years by the staff and the executive director, Justin Cave. Fast forward to 6 years later, ACE functions as the only nonprofit eye care clinic that provides quality and full optometric and ophthalmology services, providing incredibly vital eye services to those who we call our friends and our neighbors. We also do life-saving surgeries. I should have started with that. The numbers were a little bit incorrect, so I want to say that in January of this year, we provided 1,777 free exams and eyeglasses to the children of Kern County, all over across Kern County. And for those of us that are sighted and who do not have any visual problems or vision problems, Glasses simply are very essential to these children who make a huge difference in their functioning at work and at play. It used to be that eye care was an unaffordable and it was an afterthought to us. But today, ACE is trying to change that and has changed that. So on behalf of Justin Cave and to everyone who continues to play an important role in who ACE stands in our community today, I am very privileged on behalf of everyone, the Board of Directors, I stand in front of you to say, we won! I mean, thank you, Bakersfield. I meant, thank you, Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce, and to everyone.
Our next category is Small Business of the Year, recognizing the contributions of a small business, 25 employees or less, which is enhancing our community.
The nominees are Airport Valet Express. Founded in 2013 as a means of providing safe, reasonable, and reliable transportation to LAX, Airport Valet Express provides kindness transportation to active duty military, children under 10 years of age, and turnaround rides for chaperones of children or dependent adults. Form Force Incorporated. A web and mobile software platform that delivers increased productivity, compliance, and proof of service while allowing a company to remotely supervise the operational performance of their field staff in real time. It's Your Party Event Services. The party's right over there. This full-service event planning company provides the community with event rentals, decor, and design for high-quality events. While the business services all sectors and customers, owner Janine Johnson has realized a passion for helping the local nonprofit sector. She assists organizations to develop unique and profitable fundraisers. The Kern County Bridal Association. This member-based business, in partnership with the Fairy Godmother Foundation, provided a wedding to a deserving couple who had to cancel their wedding due to a medical condition. And lastly, the UPS store. It offers shipping as well as a full-service printing service for a range of customers. This local franchise expanded in 2015 through strong community outreach and developing business partnerships. The UPS store also participated in various community events.
The award sponsor is Wells Fargo, and please welcome our presenter, Ms. Alice Juarez, Area President.
Good evening. Had to catch my breath because I was unexpected earlier, so thanks, guys, for bearing with me. I'm honored to be here to present the Small Business Award for its first year, especially on behalf of Wells Fargo, because for Wells Fargo, small business is big business. That's the engine that fuels our community and really makes that difference to ensure we continue to have jobs, help families have a better life. So small business is key. Another piece we love to ensure that we support small business is Wells Fargo is known as the number one small business lender. And we've made a commitment since 2013 to give $55 billion to women-owned business. So it's really critical for us to see small businesses succeed. And this is why we're so excited about presenting the Small Business of the Year. As well as I want to thank the Bakersfield Greater Chamber of Commerce for having this award available for our small businesses out here in the community. So without further ado, the Crystal Camellia Award goes to It's Your Party Event Services.
It's Your Party Event Services is a full-service event planning company that provides the community with amazing event rentals, decor, and design for high-quality events. While the business services all sectors and customers, owner Janine Johnson has realized a passion for helping the local nonprofit sector. She has devoted countless hours and company resources to ensure local nonprofit organizations like the Housing Authority of Kern County, Bakersfield Police Activities League, and CASA of Kern County developed the most unique and profitable fundraisers possible. Small Business of the Year.
I knew I shouldn't have got my eyelashes done today because they're just going to come off now. Wow. I'm so happy to have Haley here with me tonight. Not all my employees could be here, but without them, I can't do this. And my husband, first of all, I want to thank my husband. He's been a business owner for almost 18 years, and I helped him out and raised our four kids. And yeah, that's it. And then at about 40 years old, I think I started getting a little bored. And I was approached by a company Freestyle Event Services. They said, why aren't you doing this full time? And I said, I don't know, I don't need to. And they're like, you know, you have a passion for it. And it is, besides marrying my husband and besides having my four children, it's one of the greatest things I've ever done. Because I never saw where it was going. I just thought, oh, I'm gonna have rentals and do weddings. And don't get me wrong, if you're having a wedding, I love them. I will do them. Baby showers and all this, but I never, ever expected it to go into where it's gone with our nonprofits. I have such a heart for it. I have also, in the last 3 years, as a woman-owned business, I've become part of the Housing Authority, Kern Housing Authority Board. I've become part of the PAL, Police Activities League Board. I get to work so close with Nick and Hillary at the Chamber and with the Hispanic Chamber and the Black Chamber. I love all of it. I love Kern County. And my passion is when I walk away from helping a nonprofit, when they make money, that just, it warms my heart. I love it. It makes me so happy. And also get to be part of the NAPW, the Women's Business Owners and Women of this county, and I love it. So thank you so very much. I'm so honored, and I feel so humble. And I really appreciate it.
Congratulations to all of our nominees and our award recipients. Before we get to the final award of the evening, we would like to take a moment to give special thanks to our presenting sponsor, Kern Schools Federal Credit Union, our audio visual sponsor, Media Solutions Incorporated, and our media sponsor, KGET TV17. Raymond's Trophy and Awards for sponsoring the beautiful Crystal Camellia Awards given this evening as well.
That's for you, boss. This one's for you, Derek. Well, we'd also like to thank TBC Media for helping us honor all of our nominees and streaming tonight's awards ceremony live on www.bakersfield.com. And again, thanks to all of our hospitality sponsors, Dignity Health, Mercy Memorial Hospitals, The Flower Bar, Itani Design Concepts, Klein D. Natale Goldner, Quick Signs, The Puget Family, and Wonderful Orchards for making tonight's reception possible. And of course, our thanks to the Double Tree by Hilton for going way beyond the call of duty in making this just a wonderful evening for all of us tonight. Thank you.
And thank you, DoubleTree, for keeping it nice and cool in here. Feels good. Yeah. All right, now it's time for our final award of the evening. This is the Chairman's Award. This award is chosen, as we mentioned earlier, from among all nominee submissions, and it's given to the nominee that is recognized for overall excellence.
The Chairman's Award is sponsored by the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce, and presenting this year, this year's award is the man to my left here, Steve Murray, Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce, Chairman of the Board. Steve.
Well, the beautiful Bakersfield Chairman's Award is one of the greatest privileges that I have as Chairman of the Chamber of Commerce. And I wanted to make a statement first, and that is that all the nominees are winners. And so first, I'd like to recognize everybody nominated for every category because you are all winners. You know, when I was at home, I turned on my computer, went to Wikipedia, and I looked up beautiful, and it's an adjective used to describe characteristics that provide an experience of pleasure or satisfaction. And I kind of expanded that with this category selection to sanctuary for families that my wife Vicki and I have known firsthand what it is like to be in Palo Alto or in Los Angeles with a sick child in an extended stay, and providing sanctuary for families when they're dealing with sick ones is very important in our community as well. It's therefore with great ease and happiness that I want to present the Kern County Builders Exchange members, donors, suppliers, and friends for funding and doing the work to build the Hope House at Memorial Hospital. It's providing a place of comfort and solace to families. Providing a place of comfort and solace to families while their loved ones are being cared for at Memorial for generations to come. So again, the Kern County Builders Exchange.
The concept of the Hope House Project began several years ago when the Kern County Builders Exchange wanted to give back to the community in a significant way. In August 2015, the grand opening for the Hope House at Dignity Health Bakersfield Memorial Hospital attracted hundreds of community supporters to help celebrate the generous contributions from the construction industry. The Hope House provides a comfortable place to stay so that families of patients can be close to their loved ones who are being treated at the hospital. The house has 4 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, along with all the amenities of a home, including a full kitchen, living room, and laundry facility.
Wow, I'm absolutely blown away. Thank you for the beautiful Chairman's Award, Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce. I'm a little nervous. I'm just blown away. You know, this idea for the Hope House started with a spark, and it didn't really become a flame for about 6 years. And once it did, the generosity of the construction industry in Kern County was absolutely mind-blowing. And it built a beautiful, beautiful home for loved ones to stay close to their families when they're in the hospital. And it's the 78 members of our organization that built the house and used their resources, time, and money. And I think it was beautiful when competing companies, you know, 2 different tile companies or 2 different drywall companies or framers that normally compete for work, and they came together to work on a project for our community. And they were working side by side in that house together, and it was wonderful to see. So it's a real blessing for us to also be a facilitator for families for the new Grossman Burn Center at Memorial Hospital. We're really looking forward to having our families stay there. And it warms my heart to know that right now, at this moment, there is a family staying in the Hope House, staying close to their loved one while their loved one is ill. So thank you. Thank you very, very much.
Wow, what an amazing night and a great program. And all of us at KGET TV 17 are very proud to have been a partner with the Greater Bakersfield Chamber of Commerce for tonight's awards here at the DoubleTree by Hilton. We would also again like to thank the beautiful Bakersfield Committee for all their efforts in making tonight's awards such a great event. We want to thank Hillary Haynes as well and Sarah Hinzo, who were the event coordinators for this evening.
So again, thank you to all the award recipients, the nominees, both businesses and citizens and the nonprofits, and all of you in this room who helped to enhance the quality of life in this fair city of ours. God bless you all. Thanks for coming. And we'll see you next year. Good night.